we're gonna use a guillotine to set that up. Now, when I go for this guillotine, to get the guillotine, I'm gonna go for a Kimura lock. So you're gonna notice, as we teach you this curriculum, one move directly connects to another move. All moves are connected together. So in essence, you should always have something to attack. So if I go for one move when he plays defense, it will set me up for my following attacks. I'm gonna go for my Kimura lock. So I grab that wrist, I slide my elbow, I sit up. As I grab that wrist, he's gonna grab his leg and play defense. From right here, I'm gonna reach over because his jaw is exposed. I'm gonna grab his jaw, get on my hand and my foot, pull myself back and get my arm inside, do it for an arm in guillotine. As I go for my guillotine, I fall to my side. Sometimes his head gets out. He fights the hands, gets the head out. Now notice how he got the head out and I lost my choke, but I still have his arm wrapped here. He gets the choke out. I'm gonna push the head, step over his head here, and then pull my leg out. And notice how I rotate myself to my side. I straighten my other leg over his shoulder, flatting him down. Once I flatten him down, I keep my tricep behind his thigh calf area, grabbing his belt. I kick my leg and sit up. Both my legs come sideways, palm to palm, gable grip. I want to make his hand touch the ground, so I sit up and pull myself forward, making him tap. I grab the wrist, slide the elbow. I sit up for the first Kimura attack. He plays defense here. Because he plays defense, he leaves his neck exposed. I reach around, I grab the jaw. I get on my hand and my foot. I pull myself back. I connect the arm in guillotine. As I put his head to the mat and go for this finish, he's gonna fight my hands, he's gonna pull the head out. This happens sometimes. When the head comes out, the choke arm now is gonna push the face away, the frame. Notice how I still have this arm wrapped. I have two easy options. I can just grab this wrist and make a Kimura lock, or I can push the head away and throw my leg over the top. Now that I've done this, I have separated his head from his arm. I'm gonna straighten my leg and pull myself out. And from here, I don't wanna stay here or stay triangled here, because here he can posture himself up and pick my leg up in the air and then try to pass. So I wanna try to break him down by pulling him away from his base arm. Notice how I pull him away. I keep my tricep behind his thigh. I grab the back of the pants. I kick and sit up. Both legs go sideways. I underhook the arm and I pull myself up. We'll be right back.